Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and happy Friday. Another week down, another month to go of quarantine. We can do it, you guys. We can do it. I want to talk with you guys a little bit about the next month and kind of what that's going to look like for me and share a couple of ideas with you on how to make it through the next month. And if you are someone that is trying to stay on track, trying to continue your weight loss journey during this super difficult time, then I just want to kind of share some tips with you. And I also want to put it out there that if you're not on the WW or weight loss mode right now, I totally get that and respect that 100%. But I'm here just to share some motivation, tips, tricks, discuss the workshop with you guys, continue to share my weigh-ins because I am doing my absolute best to continue on track and continue on my weight loss journey even through this quarantine because it's important to me. And like I've mentioned, it's kind of the one thing that I have control over. So I've been trying to take that control and continue to lose weight. So before I head in to listen to the workshop virtually and do my weigh-in, I wanted to kind of talk about my week. So first of all, elephant in the room, my cycle is here. I am mid-cycle, which means that generally I don't have a lot of success on the scale. I always feel gross and bloated and all the things that we feel mid-cycle. So with that being said, I don't know what my weigh-in is going to look like. Also, I've had a okay week. So I'd give myself maybe a 5 out of 10 as far as my week. I have had some pretty high point days because with being on my cycle, I'm just extra hungry. I did do Jazzercise, I think twice. I haven't been feeling the best because of my cycle, so I've been slacking on my Jazzercise a little bit. But with all that being said, I am today, Friday, it's a new day, a new set of points, a new set of weekly. So whatever day your weigh-in day is, you guys, it's a fresh start. It's a fresh start to begin a better week. So the weather is gorgeous here today. It's going to be gorgeous for the next couple days, rain a day, and then we are in the 60s. So I think today, since my husband's home, it's kind of hard for me to do Jazzercise. I'm going to go on a walk. It's a beautiful day. I'm going to take a walk today. So I think that's how I'm going to get some exercise and some movement in today. Plus, it kind of gives me a chance to just breathe and enjoy outside. So I'm starting fresh. It's a new week. I'm going to start being on track this entire week. I'm going to continue on with Jazzercise. My goal is 3 times this next week. And I'm just going to continue on and continue on with normal life and hope that next week I have a good loss on the scale. I'm going to stay for the virtual workshop and then I'll be back to share what we talked about. I always take notes during the virtual workshop and my weigh-in. So cross your fingers that I actually have a loss. Hopefully that would be very uncommon during my cycle, but I'm hoping to have a little bit of a loss and kick March off right. So I'll see you guys in just a bit. On a run from my given disaster, speed away from the holy mind. Hi friends, welcome back. I just finished my virtual workshop. It was great. It went very, very smoothly. I think people are starting to get the hang of the whole Zoom thing. I really like that we can see each other. I feel much more connected, especially when I can see my coach. I feel more connected to her and everybody else. So it was actually a really, really good workshop today. We talked about easing stress, which I think is really important right now. We all have different types of stresses during this situation. Some of us have family stress, financial stress, food stress. There's so many stresses that we can have during this quarantine and during this rough life situation. So I wanted to share with you guys some tips that we talked about as far as easing stress and some things that we can do to just make our life a little bit easier right now. Number one is something that I have been talking about for the last couple of weeks, and that is finding a new routine and focusing on what we have control over. So we don't have control over whether or not we're able to work or necessarily pay our bills or go shopping or go on vacation or see our friends or family, but we do have control over what happens within the four walls of our home, whether we are staying on track with our weight loss program or not. I mean, we have control over what we're doing with ourselves and kind of what's going on within our home. So for me, like I mentioned before I went to the virtual workshop, being on WW and staying on track is kind of the one thing that I have control over right now. I have control over what's going into my mouth, whether or not I'm exercising, what I'm doing at home. I have control over that. So that kind of eases my stress. I focus more on the things that I have control over rather than the things that I don't. And it seems to really help me not be as stressed out. Now that's what I'm doing for me. And I also mentioned if WW is on the back burner right now, I completely get that. You have to do what's best for you. But focusing on what you have control over is definitely going to help you ease the stress of this difficult time. Try to keep yourself busy. Do whatever you have to do to stay busy during the day. And if you are literally stuck in your house, find things to do. I've mentioned maybe doing some spring cleaning, maybe getting caught up on movies or shows that you are behind on because you just don't have time to do them when you're hustling and bustling and working and running all of those errands. Doing things within your home that maybe you just haven't had time to do. And for me, that's been really focusing on spring cleaning. The weather is going to be great this week, like I mentioned, so I am excited to maybe be able to get outside. Even if it's pulling weeds, it's something that I can do while within my home or around my home where I'm not interacting with others. So setting up that new routine and focusing on things that you can do within your home is going to not only keep you busy, but keep your mind off of the stress. Also, I think figuring out what is stressing you out. Is it the fact that you can't leave your house? Is it the fact that it's unknown what's going to happen? Is it financial? Really pinpointing what is causing you stress and trying to figure out what you can do to alleviate a little bit of that stress. Really just digging deep and figuring out what you can do to take some of that stress away. Another way to ease or manage stress is keeping yourself busy. And I know this can be hard, especially if you're literally staying home and you're not working and you're not working from home, finding things to keep yourself busy. And like I mentioned, cleaning, going, doing work outside, watching shows, movies, things that you just don't have time to watch normally, maybe reorganizing. I spent some time kind of organizing my house. You know, I did pick up a few things at my local Target, which is open, to do some organizing and really just shifting my focus to something that makes me feel good. And having things nice and organized and in their place makes me feel good. I've washed all the laundry that I normally don't have time to wash. Literally every sheet, every blanket, every towel in my house. I'm spending some time kind of sanitizing things in my house, just finding ways to keep myself busy. This week, my goal is to wash my windows inside and out. It's going to be warm enough that I can actually go outside and wash the windows. Just things that I always tend to put off when I'm working or when life is more normal. So find things to keep you busy, whatever those things may be. Stay connected. Use Zoom, use Skype, FaceTime, whatever you have available to stay connected to your friends and family. I just spoke with my mom on the phone yesterday for 45 minutes. Today, we just set up a Zoom call with a couple of my friends that I do Jazzercise with so that tomorrow, Saturday, we can do Jazzercise together via Zoom. It's just a way to be connected and you feel like life is a little more normal when you can stay connected to your friends and family. We're so in the day and age of texting or emailing that actually picking up the phone or connecting via Skype or Zoom or Facebook, or I'm sorry, FaceTime, is kind of out of the norm. And if we just take advantage of physically seeing our friends and family and connecting with them over the phone is really so important right now. It makes us feel, again, that sense of normalcy and connection to the people that we love. Another thing that I think is really important since we are stuck at home is de-stress your environment. Light some candles, turn on your diffuser, turn down some of the lights, make your environment comfortable and casual and de-stress. You can even turn on some soft music in the background, open up all the blinds and shades in your house and let in that natural light. Just do something within your home that makes it feel a little less stressful. Even if that means grabbing the coziest, warmest blanket you have and cuddling on the couch with your kids or your spouse or your dog or cat for a little while to de-stress your environment, I think is incredibly important. I've literally, you guys, been having candles burning all day, every day, because it makes me feel good that my house smells good, that the ambiance in my house is making it feel a little less stressful. And that has really been helping me a lot. Get in some exercise or some movement. Not only do you get out of the house, go on a walk. Go to the park and walk if your neighborhood doesn't permit walking. Walk around your block. Walk around your house. Do some movement or some exercise. It releases those positive endorphins and it just makes us feel better. It passes the time, and exercise is known to help de-stress us. So take advantage of the nice weather if you have that in your area. And if not, like I said, walk around your house. Do laps. You can still get steps in within the walls of your home. But getting some exercise and some movement in, I know especially for me, the days that I do jazzercise, I just feel better. I feel better overall. So adding some activity and some exercise in is really important during this time. And lastly, but probably the most positive way to ease stress is focus on the positive things. What's positive in your life? You have your health. Your family has their health. You're spending more time with your kids, your pets, your spouse. All of those things are positives in this situation. The sun is shining. It's beautiful out. We're feeling good. We have food in our refrigerator, our freezer, in our pantry. We have our loved ones near us more than ever. Focus on the things in your life that are positive. Take your mind off of the negative things going on in the outside world, things that we can't control, and really just spend some time focusing on what you can control and what's positive in your life. So the workshop was great. And again, just really focusing on the things we can control, keeping our environment as positive as we can, and really just making sure we're staying connected in one way or another with the people that we love. I think that is how we're going to make it through this the best way that we possibly can. I am going to be putting out some videos that talk about relieving stress during this time, how to prevent yourself from wanting to snack. Those videos will be coming out here during this next month to really help you guys stay on track if that's what you're choosing on your WW program. So let's get into this week's weigh-in. Like I mentioned, I am mid-cycle. I have been doing jazzercise, but not as consistent as I would like. I really need to change that. So starting tomorrow with this little group Zoom jazzercise session, I think that's going to help me kickstart myself back into a regular routine in jazzercise. And also in my planner for the month of April, I did put in jazzercise at least 3 days a week. So that planner is always in front of me. You guys know I use the Erin Condren planner. I do have a link down below for you guys that if you join her Insiders Club, which is free, you'll get $10 off of your Erin Condren order. So that really helps me by having that visual of that planner in front of me to remind me to do jazzercise. And now that the weather is getting better, it's a little bit easier to go outside. So just incorporating all of that, I think, is going to help me continue my WW program and continue hopefully seeing some results on the scale. So speaking of the scale, when I stepped on this morning, I actually lost 0.8. So just under a pound. I'll take it considering I'm mid-cycle. And I did have a few higher point days just because, man, was I extra hungry this last week. So this week I have some goals of my jazzercise 3 to 4 days a week. Seeing another loss on the scale and really just staying within my points is my big ultimate goal for this next week so that I can have a good loss on the scale. My overall goal for the month of April is to have a loss every single week. I don't want to have a single gain. And in order to do that, I need to be consistent and with my eating, de-stressing my environment, and exercise or activity. So those are my goals for the week, for the month of April. I want to hear from you guys. How are you guys doing? I've really been thinking about you guys every single day and hoping that you're doing well, that you're de-stressing, that you're finding things that make you happy and bring you joy, that you're getting in that activity. And if you are working the WW program, that's something that is helping you make it through this difficult time. And with another month of being quarantined at home, continue to do things that make you happy. Watch YouTube. I noticed, and I've seen this from a lot of other creators, and I'm assuming it's just because we're focused on schooling our kids and watching the news, but shockingly, YouTube views have actually went down, which has surprised me. I thought for sure we'd see a big influx of views right now because we're all stuck at home. And what better thing to do to help keep us motivated on track is to watch our favorite YouTube channels. So I know for me, that brings me joy. I've actually been watching more YouTube, but I've noticed that views and things have went down. So maybe if you have time introducing that back into your life to help keep you motivated, support us, keep yourself positive. But down in the comments, let me know how you guys are doing. Honestly, how are things going? How is your WW journey going? What have you decided as far as your weight loss? Are you on the weight loss train? Are you putting it on the back burner for a little while and focusing on other things? And let's try to do our best to stay connected as well. I'm planning on doing another live on my YouTube channel. That really was a great way for me to be connected with you guys. But I'm thinking that I would like to try to use Zoom. I don't know if that's something we can do on YouTube. I need to start doing some research. But I want to hear from you guys. I want to be connected with you guys. So leave me some comments. Let me know how things are going, how your weigh-in went, just in general, how you're doing. If you're new to my channel, welcome. I do a weigh-in every Friday. I talk about what we discussed at the workshop, aka virtual workshop, and share my weigh-in results with you guys as well. So make sure you're subscribed and your bell is hit so you're notified whenever a new video is uploaded. If you love these weigh-in videos, give me a big thumbs up. And again, leave those comments down below. Let me know how you guys are doing. I love you. I'm truly thinking about you guys every single day, and I'll see you tomorrow in my grocery haul. Bye, friends.